RedRice, and welcome to Terraria. This is a new game. Well, I mean, not a new game, but it's a game that I just started playing about a month or two ago, and it's really fun. It's the main reason I haven't been uploading, actually, which is funny. I've been too busy playing Terraria. Like, I've got insane hours on this. I've been having so much fun. I've done, like, 3 worlds so far. One really high level and got, like, 90 hours on it, and a couple more that I've been playing just on the side, fun. I've just been having so much fun with this game, and I thought that it would be a good idea to record it. So, I'm just gonna go to single player, create a new character, and, let's see, what should I do? I don't know. I don't know what I want to do. Lots of people just, go, that's a weird moon. Look at that moon, that's kind of weird. But, alright, so, I don't really know what I want to do for this, that. Make my hair a little nicer looking. And, I'll just go for my usual. Less saturated to make it look better. Dark red sleeves. Pro tip for making things look better, just, unsaturate them. Just, like, make them less saturated. That'll work pretty well. I'll, do... You have about brown pants. And nice, bright red... Bright red shoes. Make it a classic character. And, here. There we go, that's fitting. Alright. So, there's my character creator. It looks very similar to my old, to my, my main character. And for the world, we'll do, okay, I spelled that wrong. There we go. So there's our name. I'm gonna do a medium world, classic. Crimson, because, you know, my whole thing is red. It's in my name. I'm a crimson player. And let's create it. Here we're just about done. It's generating structures. Really useful throughout the game. And we're just about there. Alright. Scroll down and find it. Alright. So, here we are in a new Terraria world. Now, the first thing you always gotta do is chop down a tree. Now, unlike Minecraft, you actually get starting tools, because you can't do anything with just your hand. You can't just hand things. Oh, lemon. You actually get an axe to chop down trees and such, so I find that pretty cool. I always like that. Oh, cool, I've got iron in this world. Another interesting thing about Terraria is, there are actually, 8 ores in the game, but you only see 4 in a given world. But I'll show you that later, once we've, gone underground. But for now, I just, gotta get some wood and stuff. Okay, we've got our first enemies. These are green slimes, of course. They're probably the weakest enemies. But, they drop very useful stuff, like, gel. Gel is interesting, there is no coal in this game, so the way you make torches is actually with gel, because it's flammable. So I can make a few of those with the gel that I got. Right there when I was fighting the slimes, I actually broke a day bloom, which is an herb. And that'll come in useful for potions later. The potion system in this game is a lot different, a lot more accessible than it is in Minecraft. In Minecraft, it's more of an end game kind of thing, but in this game, you have, available to you basically from the very beginning. So we'll just break down some wood, get plenty of it. I'm gonna break this mushroom. This is gonna be the first way of restoring health. So it's gonna be useful. I'm also gonna kill some more slimes, because in a recent world that I've done, I forgot to just kill a lot of slimes at the start, and now I just didn't have enough gel to make any torches, and I was constantly struggling. But But here, this is Maxwell, my guy. They always have a different name, but he's an NPC. I can talk to him and ask him for help about stuff. And I can ask him about things. If you see a, if you see an item that has a material tag on it, you can put it in to, you can put it in to see what, like, every single item in the game it's crafted with. So this is everything you can do with a day bloom, which is a flower. Mostly potions, those are, what they're mainly used for. This large copper sword short. I butchered that one. But, this is just a copper short sword. But, pretty much all... pretty much all items in the game can come with, modifiers. Well, most tool items in the game. They come with a modifier such as large, which is plus 12 size, or godly, which is plus 25% damage, 5% critical strike chance, and 15% more knockback. And this is just a plain copper axe, so I didn't get really good RNG on that. But yeah, it's another really cool thing about this game that I like. And then another thing about this game is villagers and stuff are a lot different and a lot cooler. Like, a lot of people say that this is 2D Minecraft, and to a certain extent, yeah, I guess so. But it's just so different in so many ways. Like, there's no hunger or stamina or anything like that. But there are villagers. And, just gonna get started on a basic starter house. Like this. Quickly build a small little shelter for myself. Alright, so now that that's done, this is obviously just a plain wooden box that doesn't have much of a use, so I'll break down some of the woods that I can get outside. Oh, another thing, in this block you're actually 2 blocks wide and 3 blocks tall, which is funny. So I'll just break out both sides of this to make room for doors, which are, of course, in this game. You can't really have a surviving game without doors. So, this is the crafting system. It's not shaped, it's more like a traditional survival game. So, you can craft your workbench, which is a crafting table, basically. And I can make 2 doors to do that. 1 door there. 1 door there. Alright. And then... I'll make this wooden sword. Whoa! Got a godly sword, that's great. Now this copper short sword is a material, so I'll save that. Then I could make some armor, but I kinda don't wanna obstruct my character for now, so I'll just stay away from that for just a little bit. I'm gonna craft a chair. Oh yeah, in this game there's lots of furniture that you can actually use. That's a bunny. It's about to get killed by this slime, so I'm gonna go protect it, because it's bunny. It's a sweet bunny. Alright, so, now I can make this wooden wall. You're like, oh, wooden wall, that's cool, but isn't there, like, already blocks? Well, yeah, since this is a 2D game, to add more depth and detail to the world, there are walls that, basically you can place in the background of stuff. And here is a wood wall. This is your most basic one, really. So, just gonna place that all throughout the house, and then, to finally make it, technically habitable, I can put a light source in here. So now if I go to housing, I can, go to housing query, and this housing is suitable, so I'll put my guide in there. Now, this house isn't quite done yet, there are a few more things I'd like to put in it. So I'll just, jump to the top real quick. Clear out 4 blocks on that side, 4 blocks on this side, and I'm not sure if this house has an even center. Let's see. I can't tell. This game actually has a ruler option, so you can see. So, that's 11 blocks to that side, 11 blocks to that side. So it does have a even center. So, I will go and take out this center block, and I will craft some platforms. You can do this without a workbench. And these are incredibly useful. I'll just place them down on my roof so I can easily get in and out. And you can just press your down button to go down through them, which is really helpful since this is a side-scroller game. And there's basically your traditional house. It's like your normal terrarium house. So just place that down. You got a chair. There's a slime here. Get out. All right. So, pretty solid start. I've got a couple of day blooms, which will come in handy shortly. So I'm just gonna get some more wood, and then I'm gonna go caving. And caving in this game is a blast. You will see. It is seriously so fun. It's just, let me collect a few more materials. Oh, another thing is, it comes with a built-in mini-map. This isn't a mod, and that's incredibly useful, obviously. Alright, so, just gonna get some more wood real quick. Okay, so now that I've collected, all that, I'm gonna place down acorns to, appease Mr. Beast, make the environment happy. That's not an actual mechanic in the game, keeping the environment happy. Except it actually is, but we'll get into that later. But, for now I'm just gonna place down these, saplings with the acorns that I got from chopping down the trees. So that, you know, they'll grow back and I'll have a continuous supply of wood. But 325, not bad for early game. So, over here I found my first surface cave. Which is, really useful. And then you'll find stuff like these, pots. And they have, tons of useful stuff in them, like, torches and arrows and all that stuff. And, here's our first ore. Now, this isn't going to be really useful, because it's just copper. And, copper itself isn't that interesting. Because, I mean, our stuff right now is literally just copper, so... Yeah. So, I also got shurikens. Those are, these are okay at range damage, you know. I don't usually go for range, though. I'm more of a melee person myself. But, we'll search through these caves, not only just for ores, but for other loot as well, tungsten ore. This is good, actually, that's really good. So I'll just keep that there. Ooh, yes, good. Chests. There are tons of accessories and stuff that you can get, so, here are bottles, which are useful. Night owl potion, some light healing potions, some wood, some rope, that's really useful. Awesome iron can of worms, and wand of sparkling. This is, basically your first magic weapon. I'm also gonna take this chest, because it also costs iron bars to make them in this game. So they can actually be really useful to just, take. I'm actually, really lucky to get a nice little, starting cave at the beginning. And, you might notice that this game has dynamic lighting. And dynamic soundscapes as well. Like, there's different music and stuff. Like, listen to this. Go deeper into caves. It's really nice. Alright, so I'll take this rope that I've got here. And I'll just place this going up so that I can get up here and find my first blink root. Blink root is incredibly useful. So it's great that I found that right off the bat. Right here, this different colored dirt is actually clay, so... Oh. First zombie. So, zombies actually have a lot more variation in this game. There are tons of different looks for them. Unlike in Minecraft, where it's just like a zombie scene. So, I'll just quickly get some of this clay blocks, because they can be useful for stuff. I'm gonna kinda just... try to avoid them a little bit, because they do obviously more damage than just the slime. You probably came from above ground, though, because it is currently nighttime. Alright, so another crucial step to starting out your terraria world is, what is this? That's odd looking. But a crucial step to starting out your terraria world is to gather stone for furnaces and stuff, so I'm gonna quickly gather some stone, and I'll be right back with you. I just want to comment on how nice this music is, another reason I absolutely love this game. It's so good. It's so good. I actually have a couple of the boss themes in my playlist for chores. But, okay, I'm gonna keep on doing what I was doing. So something, obviously, that I probably didn't need to tell you, it's just like survival game thing. But there is breath, so you do need to be careful about that. As you're exploring and all that. Just, I thought that'd be... Okay, well, he's gone. Just thought that that would be worth it to mention. Alright, I think I've got enough stone for now. So, I've stumbled upon two things. while collecting the stone. One, another chest, which I'll go up there to inspect. You'll just do this. So, like I said, chests can be really, like, insanely useful, especially right now in the early game. Mainly because it's, pretty tricky to move around right now. Oh, another reason why I absolutely love this game, possibly even more than Minecraft, is you can move and play stuff while in your inventory. Ooh, this is amazing. Alright, so we've gotten our first information item. So, this is an information item. This is a radar, and it will tell you if there are enemies nearby. This is an incredible informational accessory, especially for right now. So it's really, really lucky that we got that. Oh, also there can be different colors and shapes and sizes of slime, which is real fun. I'm kind of getting owned by these monsters right now. But that's okay, everyone does in the early game. Alright, but the important thing is down here, while I was looking for stone, I noticed this continuation of the cave, so I'm just gonna kind of head on over here and see what's up there, because I found two surface chests. Well, I mean, they're not surface, because okay, alright. Oh my god, three! Okay, this is incredibly lucky. Alright, not bad. Blowpipe. Not that good, but I'll keep it. I can sell it to NPCs later. Alright. That's a lot of boys down there, so I'm gonna go ahead and skip out on that. Quickly to bait this red guy. And, that's cobweb right there. That's gonna be very useful for some things later, so let me just, craft up some more platforms and mosey on. Oh, these are grenades, by the way. Those are in this game. There's lots of interesting stuff in this game that Minecraft would just never be able to have. So, quickly head over here, because this is tungsten. This is tungsten, and that's really, really good. This is a tier 3 ore. So, that's obviously going to be really useful. So, here we've got a naturally spawning mine track. So that's cool, that can lead to some nice loot. Ow! Ow! Okay. Okay, thanks. That's great. Well, that sucked. I'm bad. But anyway, I'm just gonna quickly explore this and come across a vein of iron. So this right here is iron. This is incredibly useful. It's iron ore, can be made into iron bars. And iron bars, they extend past their gear level and are actually really, really good. And okay, good, here's some more tungsten. So in Terraria, in the early game, it's important that you have like a really long mining session to start off, because there's lots of ores and valuable things in caves. You're not always stuck at 100 health, you're not always stuck with just like naked body. You can get armor and stuff, and the amount of things that you can find and get and collect and unlock is just insane. And you also start off with a Minecraft, so that's Minecraft. You also start off with a minecart, so that's cool. But it ought to be getting at least sort of close to daytime now, so I'll probably be heading back up to the surface soon. After I check out what's going on down here, nothing too interesting. Here. Sweet. I do. I have glow sticks, which work underwater. Nothing interesting down there, though, so I'm gonna go back to where I was. Okay, so here we are, back at this area. Now, last I heard, there were some monsters around here, so gotta be kind of careful, you know how it goes. And, also, I saw what I believe is a boulder trap over here, so I gotta be careful about that. Let's see if we can spot it. Yeah, look at that. Right there, that is a boulder. Now, there isn't anything over there interesting or useful to get. In here, look at that. See, now that I destroyed that, that was a pressure plate for me to step on, so... Now, that's deactivated, so it won't fall on me and kill me. So, oh, look, a snail. Another thing that Minecraft doesn't have. But, yeah, this game is just so amusing. Ooh, this is insanely good. Especially right now, wow. Thanks, game. That just gave me a gold train. Gold is incredibly useful, but I'll tell you about money later. But, you're gonna spend a lot of your first moments of this game, at least if you want to do it right, caving. So, getting better stuff, getting upgrades, it feels really good just getting powerful and more powerful. It's really cool, but, I'm gonna do a bit more of this caving, and if I find anything interesting, I'll report back to you guys, but for now it's kinda boring to watch, really satisfying to do for a little while, then it gets kinda boring after a little bit, so I probably won't do this for too much longer. I'll kinda focus more on the surface for this first episode, but yeah, this is just the first part of every Terraria world, so I'll see you guys soon. Okay guys, it's barely been like a minute, but I have already found something interesting. See this little face on the ground? That is a dart trap. Be extremely dangerous, especially for someone who's starting out. If you just look at this little button over here, it's kind of sitting on the ground. You'll just kind of dodge and weave around this slime. It's iron, okay, cool. But I'm just gonna deal with these guys real quick. Enemies can't trigger naturally placed pressure plates, I don't think. I'm still relatively new to this game, so don't trust me. This little blob on the ground, that is a gray pressure plate. This would have shot a poison dart at me, and I would have died instantly because I only have 100 health. And it does, obviously, way more than that. So that's something to always be aware of in this game whenever you're caving. Whenever you get to higher healths, it's not as much of an issue. But it's still something you should look out for. So, pro tips, something to always keep in mind. So, I'm gonna keep on going, and I'll see you guys soon again. Alright guys, it's flown away a little bit, but here is my first cave bat. And, yeah, it's a pretty simple enemy to deal with, I mean, it's just a bat. Unlike in Minecraft, though, they are hostile. So, yeah, I'm just gonna keep going, thought that was worth it to mention. Alright guys, I found another pretty interesting thing. Here is a statue. Now, I haven't really done anything. Harpy statue. Okay. I haven't done anything with statues yet, but I knew they existed. I think you can power them to summon stuff? I'm not sure, but this ought to come in handy later. Alright, so broken that boulder. There's another boulder here, so I'll make sure to break that before it can break me. Important thing to do. Okay, I'm getting a good cobweb. It's good. Sweet. And kind of just like in Minecraft, look at that. Gold chest. But this chest is trapped. See, there are explosives and dart traps here. I'm glad I realized. See, you can see. There are more explosives here. So, gold chests are obviously, they're better than normal chests. And, this is actually a special type called the Dead Man's Chest, because it's trapped, obviously. But, I can just kind of hold this in my hand to see everything. And also, these are rubies. Oh my god, a giant Shelly, okay. Ow, no. You can press H to heal, by the way. Like a quick heal if you've got healing items in your game. deal with that. Okay, that took too long. Back to what I was doing. So that's why there were so many, things there. Ooh, mace. Okay, that's useful. Oh man, minus 11 damage, that's annoying. But it's still a lot better than what I've got that's literally double. So this is a melee class weapon. Maces, I really like them. Maces are really useful, especially in the early game. There are lots of, several upgrades for the maces. They're really fun to use, really fun to learn how to use well. I really enjoy them, so that was a good find. Yes, he dead man's chest. Ow. And it's kind of long range as well. Ow, ow, okay. That's a mother slime, so it's bigger, and it'll also drop two slimes. Need light. This is scary. This is dangerous. Ow. Death! Okay. That was kind of scary, but I lived. I will go to see another day. Whoa. I've never seen this before. Okay. Alright, so I'm just gonna point out these are gems, rubies. There are several types of gems, actually. I'll probably see one later. This is another thing trap. Alright, so I'm just gonna keep going. Alright, guys, it hasn't been that much longer, but I found a skeleton. And this guy can drop a really useful item. Now, let's see if he did. Alright, he didn't, but, hopefully I'll be able to show you later what he will drop. It's very useful. Oh, hey, there's another one. Maybe I'll be able to show you now. And nothing. Alright, well, I'm just gonna keep going, as long as these cave bats don't murder me. Come to think of it, I actually don't have too much more time, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this recall potion that I found in the chests to take myself home immediately. I know, right? So cool, so awesome. I love this game. So, now I can make this furnace. Very handy. And with this, I can make bars. So I'll just make these into copper bars. Just saw that. Bunch of iron bars. Nice. And tungsten. Tungsten is also really good. Now I need an anvil in order to make tools and stuff. And now I can craft some pretty useful stuff. So the responsible thing to do is craft the best pickaxe first. So I can go ahead and just use up all of my tungsten. Oh, might as well put down a chest while I'm at it. I'm just gonna dump everything I don't need in here right now. I need that. Alright, now come some more important things. So, I've got this mace, which is it's gonna carry me through for at least a while. I am gonna wanna make some armor, right now at least. And I'll probably want to get, I'm gonna wanna get this. Alright, so now with that, I can, the yo-yo. The yo-yo is very helpful. Oh, and it's demonic. That's great. But, yeah, this is a really useful weapon. Especially for melee in the early game. So, now I can make a sawmill with some of the iron in the chain. With this, I'm gonna be able to make a loom. With the loom, I'm gonna be able to make silk. And at the sawmill, hopefully I will have enough to make a bed. Here we go. Very handy. So, you can set your spawn at beds, of course, and clicking on the pillow, right-clicking, you will fall asleep, and the game will start going several times faster, which is, you know, useful for obvious reasons. So, here you can just take some time to get rid of some things you don't need. Yeah, that'll probably not come in handy. So, I'm gonna keep it, nice and short. I think we're gonna end off the video pretty quickly today. I'm actually gonna break this, add in a wood where it used to be, and build another room. I'm gonna build another room on here. I don't really need much more room, but someone that I need to move in will. So let me just fill this all up with walls. Make a table. Make a chair. Make a light source. And a door. Or two. Alright. To get out quick if I need to. And there's the house done. Now, in the next episode, you'll see who this house is for. For now, that's just there so that I can just get this person to move in. So, that'll be it for this episode. If you did like it, please subscribe, or at least, at the very least, like it. That'd be nice. I mean, subscribing, you'll have them. You'll have me, like, putting my videos in your recommended, but if you like, it'll just, like, you know, like, that'll do nothing to you. So, at least do that. And, I will see you guys in the next episode. See ya.